First down and 15 will be his first play from the 15. Has a hard time with the snap. Scoops it back up.
Gary Patterson felt like they can get behind these boys in safeties.
True freshman Brandon Carter trying to get outside. Opponents converting only 26% of the time.
And it's
off his back foot. Down goes Paul Hall. Paul Hall to Boyce. Now it's first and 99 and a half. Paul Hall to run, rolling to his left.
Paul, he's gained that confidence. I mentioned his touchdown interception ratio, 19 touchdowns, to only 5 picks.
Downs to 5 picks, that'll gain confidence in your coaches. Or from your coaches, first and 10 from the 16, working the option now. Keeps it himself. Byron Howard, a 3.
As we spoke to Gary Patterson this week, guys, how many times did he tell us they want Casey Paul Hall to be a more aggressive runner with the football in his hands? You're seeing a guy 6'5", over 220 pounds with this type of athlete.
Hasn't quite been that comfortable yet running the football, something they're still waiting on. Very comfortable passing it. This is Antoine Hicks, tackled by Byron Howard, gain of 7. Less than a yard. There's the quarterback sneak, easily. TCU first down, we do have a late penalty. Ball Hall with the inside gear to Wayman James into Boise State territory, and another TCU first down. Per attempt at 8.5.
TCU employs a 3 running back offense. Wayman James is that explosive guy that can take any carry to the high.
We're comfortable, Paul. Casey Ball Hall's gonna be that much more comfortable.
Boise State bringing the blitz and causing the fumble. Wayman James with the hustle to recover. A loss of 21.
And this is just a great job up top by Boise State. They're going to get penetration. I told you, they have 2 NFL caliber players at defensive end. Shea McClellin and Tyson Crawford are as good as any defensive end tandem in the entire country.
We saw TCU with some ball handling issues several times last week against Wyoming. That's where they need Paul Hall to be better.
Fake to Tucker. Dawson once again. And Wesley.
TCU to stay in those static, traditional personnel groups and run the football. Boys is very good up front. If TCU wants to have success running the football.
Down defense. Casey Paul Hall with the pump and going deep. One. Doug Martin watches with a foot injury. DJ Harper excels. Play action. Casey Paul Hall. Second down 10 now. The lone running back is Ed Wesley. Play action to Wesley. Flips it out to Tucker. Well-designed play. Paul Hall puts it right on top.
So many dynamic playmakers. Ed Wesley gets the attention of the defense. Matthew Tucker is able to outflank Shea McClellin on that play. First down, TCU.
There, it's first down and 10 from the 31. Ed Wesley trying to get around the corner. Doesn't quite do so.
Running back.
Nice pocket there, and the touch down the sideline to Wayman James. Caught the football, but he did so out of bounds.
A little wheel route out of the backfield by Wayman James. They got the matchup that they wanted.
Close.
And that's about as close as it can get.
Well, if that play is not reviewed, we'll have 3rd down and 10. Coming up for the TCU offense.
He does a lot of different things in this look, but at the end of the day, he's going to rush the passer.
Here comes McClellin. He's picked up. Paul Hall steps up. Brandon Carter. TCU only 1 yard rushing so far today. Boise State defense, they're strong. Once again, that Paul Hall up for that challenge. Gives to James here, fighting off tackles as he works his way to the right side, gains only 2.
Minute mode after this play.
Ballhawk forces that one into Josh Boyce. Boyce with the safety blitz. Ballhawk underneath. Empty backfield for Ballhawk. Steps into the pocket and fires.
I think Casey was actually throwing this ball behind Sky to Josh, who's coming in. Sky gets turned around a little bit. And that
8 field goals after starting the season, 3 out of 6. Broncos blitz. Ballhawk beats it. Calm in the pocket.
You know, you look at the poise, a young quarterback. Doesn't panic under the blitz. Understands that Ed West is coming out of the back.
Broncos rush 3. Ballhawk flushed out of the pocket and just gets rid of it. And now 4.
Lead after only rushing for 12 rushing yards, I would not have believed you.
Broncos with a blitz on the first play, causing the fumble. To the pass for the entire season. The pass heavy in the first. Back to the run. And Wesley right down to the turf. 2 yards out. The other a loss of 3. Ballhawk to his right. As he says with a smile. 3rd and 13. Screen pass to Raymond James. Breaks a tackle. And that'll be a TCU first down. What a play call. Love the on the ground coming into this one. That's a huge pass play to set up 1st and 10. Boise State defense in the backfield once again. Chase Baker leading the way. Just fun. Fakes to Wesley, keeps it himself. Fumble! And Wesley cut. 4 out of 6 converting 3rd down in the first half. And Wesley off the right side. Hightower there.
Establish his run again. Good run by Ed Wesley.
2nd down 4. Paul Hall going to keep it himself. 3rd down situations into 1st downs.
He's a safety. He's not a corner. So he's being asked to do something that he normally does not have to do.
Casey Paul Hall, 307 yards passing already. Look at that pocket. Wayman James against linebacker Byron Howell. Take that every single time. Wayman James now back to the running.
Guys, he's got the left 3 technique over the right guard.
Ball has stepped.
And the quarterback still learning the game.
Watch Wayman James out the backfield. He's matched up with Byron Hope 1-on-1.
James stays in the block, and Ball
has poise. He's a big quarterback. Watch him stand right there in the pocket. He knows.
This is Matthew Tucker trying to cut it back. Linebacker blitz. Ballhawk rolling. Raymond James and Matthew Tucker in the backfield. This is Raymond James to the 2-yard line. Yeah. Off his back foot. Josh
Porter. I just kicked the extra point.
Casey Ballhawk can keep it himself, but can he get there? Just barely.
Football swarming to the man with that Wilson in his hand.
Boise State comes with a blitz. After as much as I trusted Andy Dalton, but off to a heck of a start earning that trust. Casey fires numbers, people start to trust you.
And this is a very impressive throw. Shea McClellin hits Casey just as he releases the football.
Making the option, popping back up, wants to fire, does so to end the scrimmage. Pop back up, way underthrown, Lee Hightower there.
And you get upset with, which is different from the environment they had at UC Davis at the time.
Casey Paul Hall to Ed Wesley. They would. 2nd down 7. Ed Wesley to the left side. 3rd down and 3. Broncos showing blitz. Here they come. Touch pass to Wesley, overshoots him. Shea McClellin providing the coverage. Fires that one away. Ballhawk flicks it out to Brandon Carter. Byron Hout there. 3rd down and 6. pass, stepping in and firing.
Team that hadn't lost at home since the 1800s.
Bahal firing to Skyball. 1:28 left, trailing by 7. Working the underneath stuff again and again, a completion.
Casey has to be careful. Boise is going to bring some pressure. Don't make a mistake.
There's the pressure. Bahal flushed out. And Bahal now 23 out of 36, 448 yards. The double pump.
That's a decision to have the football on the left hash.
Rolling out and firing. Josh Boyce with the catch.